فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. When the sharh of the kitab متن الأجرومية, we were relying on the sharh تحفة السنية في شرح مقدمة الأجرومية written by محمد محيدين عبد الحميد. What's the name of the author of this book? So inshallah ta'ala, that is the book inshallah ta'ala that we're going to take. We stopped at the Asma'ul Khamsa. We spoke about the rest. We now have to speak about the Asma'ul Khamsa. I guess then if we finish Asma'ul Khamsa, then we finished everything, right? That was the last from the eight things that we're meant to explain, right? Did we explain all the other seven? We did Ism Mufrad, we did Muthanna, we did Jam'u Taksir. Did we do Jam'u Dhakr Salim? Did we do Jam'u Al-Salim? Plural Feminine. We did. Did we do فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بأخيره شيء؟ Did we do أمثلة الخمسة أم أفعال الخمسة؟ We did. We've got the last one, the eighth one left, which is أسماء الخمسة. Once we do that, we are going to know the eight things that we do إعراب of. Those are the eight that we do إعراب of. اسم مفرد، مثنى، جمع التكسير، جمع ذكر السالم، جمع مؤنث السالم، فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء، الأفعال الخمسة، which we say is, should correctly be called أمثلة الخمسة. And last but not least, الأسماء الخمسة. Those eight are what we do إعراب of. Remember, we took them each out from what? اسم مظهر. اسم مظهر gives birth to how much? Six of them. And the أفعال gives birth to how much? Two of them. If you just remember that, wherever you come to this chapter of إعراب, these are the eight things that you analyze. Grammatically, we only analyze these eight. We don't analyze anything else. The rest are mabni. Good. So let's take the last one, which is أسماء الخمسة. What's أسماء الخمسة? You can go to the sharh of Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. He says, وأما الأسماء الخمسة فهي هذه الألفاظ المحصورة التي عدها المؤلف وهي. He said, it's these restricted letters which the author has mentioned for you that he brought. وهي, and they are أبوك أخوك حموك فوك and ذو مال. And we change it into ذو علم. We don't want to connect people to money, so we say ذو علم. Those five. So it's أبوك أخوك حموك فوك ذو علم. Those five. Those five are what? What are those five? Those are the Asma'ul Khamsa. It's on the book for every one of you. I'm going to write on the board, inshallah ta'ala. So it's أبوك أخوك حموك فوك and we say ذو علم. صح؟ We don't want to say ذو مال. Are we all together? Those five. The author mentions it in the book. If you look at the Matan Ajrumiyah, he mentions it in there. Are we all together? Then look what he says. He says, وهي ترفع بالواوي. We're going to study what it means ترفع بالواوي. We'll take that inshallah ta'ala very soon. So no need to stress yourself out. عن الضمة تقول حضر أبوك وحضر وأخوك وحموك ونطق فوك وذو مال وكذا تقول هذا أبوك وتقول أبوك رجل صالح وقال الله تعالى وأبونا شيخ كبير من حيث أمرهم أبوهم وإنه لذو علم إني أنا أخوك فكل اسم منها في هذه الأمثلة مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الواو نيابة عن الضمة وما بعدها من الضمير أو لفظ مال أو لفظ علم مضاف إليه. Beautiful. All of that is the grammatical analysis that the Sheikh mentions. We don't want to know that now. We're going to come to that. This is what concerns us. وعلم أن هذه الأسماء الخمسة لا تعرب هذا الإعراب إلا بشروط وهذه الشروط منها ما يشترط في كلها ومنها ما يشترط في بعضها. He says, اعلم know that these أسماء اعلم know أن هذه الأسماء الخمسة these five nouns, these five sisters, لا تعرب, they are not grammatically analyzed هذا الإعراب إلا بشروط, unless there are conditions met. وهذه الشروط, and these conditions, منها ما يشترط في لفظ كلها. There are conditions that are stipulated on all five. ومنها, and there are also conditions يشترط في بعضها, which is conditioned in some. And we're going to see, inshallah ta'ala, it's only two of them. It's only two, ذو and فو. ذو and فو are the only two which have specific شرط. Inshallah we'll see that بإذن الله الكريم. أما الشروط التي تشترط في جميعها فأربعة. أما الشروط التي تشترط في جميعها فأربعة شروط. The conditions that are placed in all of them are four. I wrote them on the board for you guys. So if you go and look at the board, نعم. If you look at the board, you find شروط إعراب الأسماء الخمسة. Okay? The condition of doing إعراب of the five sisters. The first one is عام, meaning the reason why it's called عام, it enters all five of them. And there are four conditions that enter all five of them. The first one is أن تكون مفردة. مفردة. And we'll explain what it means, inshallah ta'ala. I mean, let's explain it now. So the word, the first one is أن تكون, for it to be what? مفردة. So it can't be مثنى. The أسماء الخمسة cannot come as مثنى. It can't come as a جمع. It can't be. You can't say أبواكما. If you say أبواكما, it means both of your fathers. أبواكما means what? Both of your fathers. Look. So if the word, that was أبوكا, it turns out to be أبواكما. أبواكما, is it مفرد or is it مثنى? It's a مثنى, it's two. أبوكا is what? مفرد. The condition is for it to be مفرد. If it becomes أبواكما, it's إعراب, it's something else. Okay, we'll speak about the إعراب and the details of the إعراب later. Are we all together? So the first condition is أن يكون, أن تكون مفردة. It has to be singular. The word always has to come as a singular. Your father, your brother. Does that make sense? It can't come as you two's father. Does that make sense? No. Good. So you can't say جاء أبوكما. It's something else. Or if you say جاء أباؤكم. أباؤكم is what? جمع. Plural. Your fathers, all of you. Does that make sense? So it can't come as a مثنى ولا جمع. Does that make sense? It has to be singular. That's the first condition, all of them. All of them. All five of them, they can't come as what? They can't come as plural, and they can't also come as what? Good. The second condition that the author, rahimahullah, mentions is أن تكون مكبرة. أن تكون, that it is مكبرة. That the word is what? It has to be what? It has to be mukabbar. What does it mean that it has to be mukabbar? Some things in the Arabic language, you can do what is known as tasghir of it. If you want to say, Shaykh Albani rahimahullah was once asked, they said to him, Shaykh Al-Allam, they praised in front of his face. Shaykh Nasir said, I am not a student of knowledge. I am a what? What did he say? Huh? What did he say? Tuwaylib. Tuwaylib is literally the word talib. Tuwaylib means I'm a baby student of knowledge. Rahimahullah. That means tawadu'i. That was from his humbleness. Rahimahullah. So what happened? What did he do to the word? He made the word musagara. He done tasghir of the word. Does that make sense? The word abuka, ubayyuka, if you say it, it's tasghir. Ubayyuka is what? Ubayyuka is tasghir of the word abuka. Are we together? Let me write on the board. If you say u, ubayyuka. Ubayyuka. The word ubayyuka is a what? What is it? It's tasghir of the word abuka, your father. We don't want that. The author says, no. Let it be abuka, mukabbara. It has to be big. Like talib, that's a big word. You can't make it a baby. Don't do tasghir of it. Does that make sense? Don't make it small. The second condition is, an takuna mukabbaratan. That the word is a what? It's a mukabbara. It has to be mukabbara. Good. Are we all together before I move on to the... Umair is tasghir, they say, of Umar. Mm-hmm. They say that. Number four. The fourth condition is antakuna idafat. So antakuna mudafatan. Antakuna mudafatan. That the word is, what is it? It has to have mudaf. What does it mean to have mudaf? When you say father, مثلا, you have to say your father. I'm Muhammad's father. You need to attribute this father to somebody. What do you say? جاء عليكم السلام أخوك is your brother. I'm attributing the brother to you. There has to be that attribution. You can't just say جاء. Allah, let's take Quran as an example. What did Allah say in the Quran? إن له أبا شيخا كبيرا. إن له أبا. He has a father. But the word father here has not been attributed to him. Where's the mudaf? There's no there. إِنَّ لَهُ أَبًا. أَبًا here, the word أَبًا has not been attributed. It was not said أبوك, أبو محمد, أبو this. It hasn't been said. And if that happens, then the إعراب becomes حركة. Anytime one of these conditions are missing, the إعراب becomes a حركة, not the حرف واو. Or the ياء. Or the ألف. None of those. It doesn't become the huruf. It goes back to the i'rab of a muthanna. A mufrad. It's a mufrad. You deal with it like it's a mufrad. Turfa'u bil dhamma, wa tunsabu bil fatha, wa tujarru bil ya'. Like when it meets these conditions, turfa'u bil wawi, wa tunsabu bil alifi, wa tujarru bil ya'i. Wa alaikum salam. We'll speak about the issue of i'rab inshallah ta'ala soon. That's the word. Does that make sense? This, the word akhuka, abuka, this has to be attributed. There has to be idafa, attribution. Does that make sense? You have to attribute it. Whether you attribute it to a dhamir or a ism dahir is not a problem, but you have to attribute it. Does that make sense? For example, that's why you always keep seeing that kaf at the end. Why do you keep seeing that kaf at the ending? It's attribution. Ah, your father. We can't just say Abu. Are we you together? That's a condition. Mudafa and takuna mudafa. It has to have idafa with it. Whether that idafa is ism dahir or ism mudmar. Whether it's a pronoun or whether it's an apparent noun, there has to be a idafa. we'll speak to that. We speak about that. And we're going to restrict what type of idafa that you can't have in the next condition to come. But does that make sense first? Yeah? Huh? It is. Ilmin is a mudaf. Dhu and then ilm. All the things that you're seeing, what are you seeing? You're seeing attribution every time. It's being attributed to something. Are we all together? And inshallah ta'ala, the word idafa, don't expect to understand it in its full meaning until, because we're going to come to it, it's all in the book. But I just want you to have an idea. There has to be attribution. Things even become more clear to you as we go on. It starts to become much more clearer. Okay, I'm now understanding that very well. I can reassure you that. It's just that first stage where you just have to have a bit of understanding, a bit of patience, is what's needed. This is what Nahwa is. Nahwa is one of the easiest sciences, right? Sah? Is it? What do you think, Imran? You don't think it's one of the best, easiest sciences? What do you think, Hamza? Easy? It's very hard. Abbas, you like it. But it's hard. Sad. I don't really think it's hard. I personally don't think it's hard. My personal opinion. I just think it requires focus. And that's what many of us don't like. That's all it requires. It just needs... The other sciences, they'll just go into you somehow without even you paying full attention. But no. Grammar wants full attention. And that's what we don't like. Okay, have we understood those 4 points? Those three conditions. Let's move on to the fourth condition. The last condition, which encompasses all of the... What does it encompass? All of the Asma'ul Khamsa, all of them. The five Asma'ul Khamsa, Abuka, Akhuka, Hamuka, Fuka, Fuki, Dhu, Malik. All of those five, these four conditions are all taken. The fourth and the last condition is, أن تكون إضافتها لغير المتكلمين. That the thing that you're doing the idafa to, the thing that you're doing the idafa to, it has to be other than ya mutakallim. It can't be ya mutakallim. Meaning, you can ascribe to anything else except the ya mutakallim. The ya mutakallim is what? Is like Abi by father. As long as you're not attributing this father to yourself by saying Abi by that ya, if you're not using it, any other idafa is accepted. Does that make sense? So, Abuka, you can use it because that idafa is what? Is it ya mutakallim? Is that kafa ya mutakallim? No, it's not. But if you say Abi, even that though it meets the criteria of it being a mufrad, mukabbar, mudafat, but it misses the fourth condition. What's the fourth condition? This ya is ya what? Is ya al-mutakallim. As long as that idafa is not ya mutakallim. That's the only exception from the idafa that it can't have. Why and what's the reason behind it? And where mutammimatul ajrumiyya and the other books will take. What? Why? Why specifically this one? Does that make sense? No. Okay. Okay. We just said right now that the word has to be singular. It also has to be mukabbar, I mean it has to be big. We can't smallen the word. We also said it has to be attributed, right? We said it has to be what? Attributed. So the word abu, father, you have to, if you want it to be asma'ul khamsa, if you want it to fall under the criteria of asma'ul khamsa, these five, they have to be attributed. It has to be idafa here. It has to be attributed. Quick, are we all together? Good. The fourth condition just says, as long as the idafa is not ya al-mutakallim, it can't be the ascription of a ya, it can't. That's the only exception, that's the only ascription that I don't allow. So you can ascribe it to abuka, abuki, abukuma, abuku, you can say that. Doesn't matter. Are we all together? You can attribute the father to what? Two people. It's one father. The father's not two. It's only one father. You attribute it to two. You can do that. Are we all together? Are we all together? As long as it's not attributed to a ya al mutakallim.
If you attribute it to their father or your father too, doesn't it go against the first?
No, because the father's not plural. The father's the only one. It's the father that shouldn't be plural. You shouldn't say your fathers. Does that make sense? If the word to father, it becomes abawakuma, aba'ukum. If it becomes aba'ukum, means your fathers, each person's father. There's many fathers here. But if I attribute one father to four kids that he gave birth to, the father's still one. He's mufrad. Does that make sense? Are we all together? So those are the four conditions. Let me one more time repeat it. I feel like students are still not with me. The first condition is that antakuna mufrada. The word has to be singular. Okay, the word abu is one. The word has to be singular. Akhu has to be one. Hamu has to be one. All of it has to be one. One, 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 one. Okay, good. It has to be mukabbara. Mukabbara here we said, alla yakuna musagara. It can't be tasgheer. You can't make the word baby. In Arabic, this is something that you do. It's common. Good. It can't be mudafa. Mudafa means here. Sorry, it has to be mudafa, sorry. It has to be attributed. That's why you always generally are going to find that there's always going to be abuka, akhuka. That kaf is there always, generally speaking. Are we all together? Does that make sense? Generally, that kaf is always there. The reason why that kaf is there is because it's the condition. The condition, which is an inscription, your father. You can't just say a father. If you say a father, it's not Asma'ul Khamsa. It's not Asma'ul Khamsa, it's something else now. Are we all together? Look at the ayah, Allah says, Inna lahu aban. Aban. That's a father. Does that make sense? Because the word Inna lahu aban, shaykhan, kabiran, fakhud ahadana makana. Inna lahu aban. Because the ayah said aban. Aban is not attributed to anybody. It's actually it's a word which is what? Murakkar. It's a word that's not mu'arraf. Does that make sense? And the idafa makes the word known because you attribute it to a father, to a particular person's father. But this time, whose father? It's a father. This is not Asma'ul Khamsa. Don't bring it into this category because it misses one of the conditions. Are we all together? It misses what? It's missing one of the conditions. So we don't deal with it like Asma'ul Khamsa. The reason why we keep saying it's not Asma'ul Khamsa, Asma'ul Khamsa has a specific way to deal with it. There's a unique way we deal with Asma'ul Khamsa. And a unique way that we handle it. Are we all together? No. Okay, good. The third one is, it has to be attributed. That's what the third is. There has to be attribution. Wallahi, brothers, if you ask me the same question 50 times, I'm more than happy to answer it. Don't worry. You can repeat it and repeat it and repeat and repeat it and repeat it as long as we understand. Okay? Don't worry. Okay, mudafa just means attribution. It's unrestrictedly said it's attributed. Sah? That's the third condition. And takuna mudafa, that is attributed faqat. The fourth one comes and it says, but not a ya'al mutakallim. That's what the fourth one is saying. As long as it's not with ya'al mutakallim. Oh, that's it. So the third one is that it has to be attributed. Because remember, who can you attribute it to? You can attribute it to other people as long as it's not you attributing it to yourself with the ya'al mutakallim. We'll go together. The reason I don't want to say you can't attribute it to yourself because you could attribute it to yourself if you bring ism zahir and it's asked your dad. Sah? Even though it sounds very awkward, but it could still be done. And it's your dad that came. If you, for example, say, Ja'a Abu Abdurrahman. Sah? Did I not attribute it? Sah? I did bring my dad. I did mention it. So that's why I want to avoid those using that. But what I can't do is I can't say, Ja'a Abi, my father came. Even though I've attributed it, I've met the third condition, I have attributed it, I'm missing the fourth condition, which is I am not allowed to bring a ya'. If I bring that ya' of the mutakallim, then no. Okay? Ja'a Akhi, my brother came. We all together. If you bring that, then it's good. Good. These are main. For now, it's only five. These are five for us. In the Mutamimah, they add another one. They add a fourth, a sixth one, Hanukkah. Hanukkah comes on the sixth, Mutamimah to Al-Ajrumiyah. But even that's disputed whether it should be added into the criteria. And there's a reason why Ibn Ajurum had left that one out. But we'll speak about that in the Mutamimah. Are we all together? So here we have Mufrada, Mukabbara, Mudafatan, Idafatuha لغير الياء المتكلم. Are we all together? Very good. Are we all together? Are we all on the same page? Yeah? We're all on the same page on that. Good, mashallah. Now let's go to the conditions that are specific to two of the what? They are specific. Remember we said the conditions are two types. Shurut, which are, he mentions here. Remember he said it, وَهَذِي الشُّرُوط مِنْهَا مَا يُشْتَرَطُ فِي كُلِّهَا. Those four are conditioned on all of the five. وَمِنْهَا مَا يُشْتَرَطُ فِي بَعْضِهَا. And some of the conditions are stipulated where? Huh? In some of them. It's conditioned in what? In some of them. So now let's go into the ones that are conditioned in some of them. فخرج باشتراط الإفراد ما لو كانت مثنى. We explained all of that. Don't worry. All of that page is what I explained for you guys. Then the Sheikh says, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid says, وأما الشروط التي تختص ببعضها دون بعض فمنها أن كلمة فوكا. So there you go. We have two words now. The two from the five that are an exception. It's the word ذو and فو. ذو علم and فوكا. Are we together? Can anybody right now guess from the top of their head what ذو is going to have as a condition? Just as roughly, have a rough guess. Have you? Look at the five words I gave you. What does ذو have different from the rest? Listen. What is it? Yeah, there's no calf there. Beautiful. See, just focus. That's all it is. The word ذو is the only one that we haven't used the calf for. The rest we kept saying abuka, ahuka, fuka, ذو مال. So from its conditions, it's going to be something to do with this, right? Something connected to this is going to probably be brought up, right? Good. That's nice. We're going to come to that. And that's that part. It's this part of the condition. ذو, this one, what I wrote here, is أن تضاف إلى اسم جنس ظاهر.